There's a lot that we don't yet know about what's gonna happen with Donald Trump over the next year or two. Is he actually going to eventually run for president once again? Is he going to potentially face legal charges in the investigations that are facing him? Could he, as a result of those charges, end up behind bars? And if one of those things happened, would it actually stop the other from going forward? You'd expect so. You can't have a president behind bars, right? Or can you? Apparently, a case can be made. And joining us now is a journalist who spoke with some legal experts about the possibility that Donald Trump could serve as president from prison. We're joined by policy correspondent for Insider, Robin Brevender. Welcome to the Damage Report.
Hey, thanks for having me.
Very glad to have you on. So before we get into some of the legal specifics, what was it that led for you and your co-author on this piece to consider this as an option, something to look into?
Yeah, it's interesting. We talked to legal experts about this, and a lot of them told us we were jumping the gun, but then they said, you know, we've had a crazier things that we thought would never happen, so worth considering. This came from a conversation we had had last year about whether the Secret Service might be responsible for removing Trump from the White House, if it came to that. It didn't come to that, of course, but then we started talking about, well, would the Secret Service follow him to prison if he went there, and found out the answer was yes. So then we wondered if he could run again if he ultimately is in prison, which is of course very hypothetical at this point.
Hold on for one second. When you say that they would follow him there, if he were to be sent to prison, he would continue to have Secret Service guards?
Absolutely. That's the takeaway from former Secret Service agents we talked to. He's the former president, he's entitled to lifetime Secret Service benefits.
Wow, that is amazing. Okay, well, look, I guess that's not the most shocking part of this, but so I think I would assume one of the reasons the legal experts thought that you might be jumping the gun is most sane people, but sane people who haven't really paid attention to politics for the past few years, would assume that were he to go to prison, he wouldn't win the nomination. Really fast, obviously, you take it as a possibility that that might happen for the rest of this to be possible.
Yeah, absolutely. And in fact, he wouldn't be the first person running for president from prison. We looked back in the history books, and Eugene Debs ran from prison for the Socialist Party in 1920. Lyndon LaRouche ran in the 90s. So certainly possible to run from prison. And then the legal experts we talked to said, theoretically, he could govern from prison too. The only real constitutional requirements, you have to take the oath of office. That could be done anywhere. And he has to periodically address Congress. So one of the professors we talked to suggested he could do that from Zoom wearing an orange jumpsuit in a prison cell.
And obviously there is nothing stopping someone who is currently serving time from running. Is it possible that in advance of that, some law could be passed, some executive order, but even then there would be a question of its constitutionality?
Yeah, anything like that would certainly go to court. Professors think that that's very legally dubious. Really, it would probably take a constitutional amendment, which, as we all know, is really hard to do.
Mm-hmm. And so, okay, let's say he's allowed to. Okay, he can campaign behind bars. He can theoretically get elected behind bars. It's America. Crazy-ish things have happened. Once he's president, wouldn't he have quite a bit of power to change his own legal situation, his own housing situation?
Yeah, absolutely. One possibility that was brought up, if he's in a federal prison, he would be in charge of the Bureau of Prisons. So he could theoretically designate the White House as a prison for himself. So a lot of opportunity for him to change things. He could try to pardon himself. There were a lot of questions about whether he might pardon himself before he left office last time. So if he's in a federal prison, he could try to pardon himself this time around, which is also legally dubious, but the courts would have to work that out. If he's in a state prison, if it's a different story, and he might be at the mercy of a governor of whatever state he's imprisoned in, or the parole board there to try to pardon him.
Yeah, I get that you're saying it's legally dubious, although I guess it would be about as legally dubious as preemptively pardoning himself for things he hasn't yet been charged with, correct?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. All of this is so fun. Okay, well, I guess finally, for the legal experts that you talked to the extent that they express this, and to the extent that you would like to express this. How likely is any of this actually happening? Do you believe that the Republican Party would go along with this, that the voters would support him in a Republican primary were he to campaign from behind bars and to be elected? Does this seem within the realm of possible for you and for the experts you talk to?
Likely, certainly not. But you know, I talked to someone who said we're going down in sort of cuckoo land. And then after a minute, he was like, you know, we've seen crazier things. I'm not going to rule it out. So likely no, but possible yes.
Okay. Well, look, I'm glad that you're doing this work and that we get to have this talk far in advance of it, because above all else, I want my audience to be prepared for what might be coming. And you know what? After the past few years, why not this too? Why won't this be the next chapter? Anyway, Robin Brabender, really appreciate your work and for joining us on the show. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.